with the outside and the inside with the inside. So in this case, the outside is a 1. So it's going to be 1 times 1 is going to be 1. 3 times 6 is going to be 18. So it should be the square root of 18x. This one is going to be 3 times 10 is going to be 30x. Any questions so far? I'm not finished, all right, but I need you to try to think what I did. Does anybody have any questions so far? Yes. 3 times 10. Okay, now you have to break it up. 2 times 9. Right away, by now, you should know that 9 is a perfect square. What's the square root of 9? So I'm going to take a 3 out, and I'm left with what on the inside? 2 what? Be careful, okay, 2x. This one right here is going to be 2 times what? And then 15 can be broken down as 3 times what? Any questions on what I said so far? Now look, this one doesn't have 2, this one doesn't have 2, and this one doesn't have 2. So all of this has to stay. So leave it as 30x. We tried to take something out, but we were unable to. Now, can I add the 3 plus that 1? Why not? Because it's not the same what? What's the number in the inside called? Radicand. The radicands are not the same, so you can't do anything else. Is everybody clear on number 1, or in this case, number 2? All right, number 3. This is FOIL, okay? Now, I make mistakes, and so do you guys. So watch what I do. Nico, will you please not eat? So watch carefully. What is a negative times a positive?
Negative.
A negative. And what is 2 times 5?
10.
Jacob, are you with me? All right. Let's go to the next one. What is a negative times a negative? Anybody? A positive. Remember, 2 negatives is going to be a positive. All right, now look. Do I multiply the 2 times the 10, 2 to the 5, or the 2 times the 1?
The 1.
So what is this one times that one? 2. 2 what? 2 square root of 5. Any questions about the first level or the first layer? Now we're going to the second level. Okay? Here we go. What is a negative times a positive?
Negative.
A negative. Now look up. How much is this one times this one? Anybody? How much is this one times that one? How much? A negative 15. Square root of 5. How come I don't multiply that 5 and this 5? One's on the outside and one's on the inside. Listen to what she said now because she is right, okay? But I want all of you to understand, all right? So here we go. What is a negative times a negative?
A positive.
All right. So how much will this one times this one be? Anybody? Anybody, how much is this one times this one? Negative 3 what?
Square
root of 25. Why do I multiply that 5 and that 5? They're both where?
On the inside.
On the inside. Is everybody clear on that? All right, now here we go. What's the square root of 25? Now, what do I do with these two? I multiply them. So 5 times 3 is what?
15.
So all of this is really 15. Is everybody clear on that? All right, now we're going to do 3 words. Does anybody know what those 3 words are? Combine what? All right, here we go. So how much is a minus 10 and a plus 5?
5.
A positive 5. Very good. Yes, sir. Which one? Right here? All right. What is the square root of 25, Nico?
5.
So there's nothing left. So all of this is really 5. So 3 times 5 is 15. You with me? There's nothing left in the inside. All right, good question, but here we go. Is this one and this one, are they like terms?
Yes.
Why? Same inside. Very good, Frank. All right. So do I have more pluses or do I have more minuses? Do I have more pluses or more minuses? How many more? So I'm going to put, very good, a negative 13 what? Square root of 5. That is your answer. Any questions on how to do number 3? I know this is kind of tough, okay? We've been spending a lot of time on it, so I need you to stay with me, okay? I mean, I'm trying, okay? All right, this one right here. This is basic stuff, so watch. How much is x plus x? 2x. 1 candy bar plus another candy bar equals how many candy bars? 2. Okay, let me break it down so some of you guys can understand it, okay? One girlfriend plus another girlfriend equals what?
Trouble.
Right. But it's really 2 girlfriends. All right, next. How much is x times x?
X squared.
When you multiply, what do you do with the exponents? You add them up. Excellent. All right, last one. We're adding fractions. What must we find? Excellent. Very good. Now, how did I teach you to do this? What did I tell you? All right, you wasn't here. All right. And I appreciate you trying. How did I say it? Raise your hand if you know. See, I'm checking your memory. I know what I said. I said take the biggest number. Now think back. I bet you remember me saying that. Take the biggest number. Does 3 go into this number evenly?
No.
Double it. Does 3 go into that number evenly? Triple it. Does 3 go into that number evenly?
Yeah.
Guess what this number is? Guess what it is? It's called my least common denominator. That wasn't a trick question, okay? All right, look here. 3 times what is 15?
5.
So you have to do a 5. This is what you were taught. 5 times what is 15? So you got to do a 3. Any questions so far? Watch what happens now. Pay attention back there. What's 2 times 5? So put 10 over 15. What's 1 times 3? 3 over 15. Do I have the same denominator? What's my final answer? Excellent. 13 over 15. It's not hard. You have to know how to do fractions, I'm telling you, okay? When I'm making something, I have to know how to use that measuring tape. It matters. If I cut it too short, it matters, okay? All right, put away your bell work, please. Now, how many in here, and I need you to be honest now, because I don't have extras. How many of you in here did not get a new book? Put your name on here. Go over here, did not get a new book. All right. All right, here we go. I need you to open up to page 20. Go to page 20.
What do you want them to do with their old one?
They can just leave it on the table. All right, look up. Shh, watch now. I am going to give you back your old test, but I need to teach this to you. So right now, put page 20, and I'm going to make up some of these, okay? Because I can't do your work for you. Ladies, right now I want you to put the square root of 20 times the square root of 3. Write that down. All right, now, I want you to work that problem. Multiply those two. Copy it down right here and put some kind of an answer right there. Don't call out. Write it down and put an answer. Multiply. I'm not going to do the same ones in the book. I'm making some up. Okay. I'm trying to get you ready for this. All right, here we go. What's 1 times 1? What's 3 times 20? What am I going to do with that 60? Got to break it down. Break it down. Right now, I want you to break it all the way down. Come on. Break it all the way down. 2 times what?
30.
2 times what?
50.
3 times what? Do I have a pair?
Yeah.
All right. What's 2 times 2? What's the square root of 4? So take a 2 out. What's my final answer? 2 what?
2 square root of 15.
Is everybody clear on that? Everybody got it? All right. Try this one. Write that down. I know it looks weird because it's an exponent. Write it down. All right, now look up here. Which number is my root on the first one? The bottom number. Very good, Peyton. The bottom number is the root. Write that down. What's the top number called? That's your exponent. Write it down, guys. The bottom number is the root. So look up here. This is now the square root of 5 to the first power. What is the next one going to be? Square root of 2 to the what? To the first power. The bottom number is the root. Now look up here. What's 2 times 5? What's my final answer? Square root of what? Square root of 10. Let's try one more. Copy this one down. 3 to the 1/2 power times 2. I'm sorry. 3 to the 1/3 power. I want them both to be 3s. I'm trying to give you some similar to the book. All right, you ready? Look up here. Which one is my root? The top one or the bottom one? So put the square root of 3. Which one is my root? So put the cubed root of 3. The cubed root of 3. All right, now look. I got to back up on this, so watch. since the roots are different, the way it's written, you cannot do anything with it. So I need to go back to this type. So put 3 1/2 times 3 1/3. Copy that down. All right, now watch. Do I have the same base? Listen to what I just said. Do I have the same base? All right. What do I do with the exponents if I have the same base? Do I add them? Do I subtract them? Do I multiply them? Or do I divide them? Got to add them. So put 3 to the 1/2 plus 1/3. You have to be able to add those fractions. What's my least common denominator for these two fractions? Anybody know? It is 6. Take the biggest number. I just tried to show you that. Take the biggest number, 3. Does 2 go into 3? No. Double it. Does 2 go into 6? Yes. Now, 2 times what is 6? So put a 3. 3 times what is 6? So put a 2. So I get 3 to the 3 over 6, which is 1/2, plus 2 over 6. Now what's 3 plus that 2? So I get 3 to the 3 plus 2 is 5. So I get 3 to the 5 over 6. I think I lost some of you on this one. Right?
Yeah.
All right. So let's try one more. Write this down. Put 5 to the 2/5 times 5 to the 1/3. Copy that down. Do I have the same base? I don't have the same base. Do I have the same base?
Yes.
So what do I do with my exponents? I have to add them. So write this down. Put 5 to the 2 over 5 plus 1 over 3. And off to the side of your paper, I want you to add those up. You must find the least common denominator. I need you to try. I mean, you should be able to add fractions. Now, you came in, and most of you could not add fractions. You have to find the same denominator. Take the biggest number, double it, triple it, until you find the one that works. Thirty more seconds. Can anybody tell me what is the least common denominator?
15.
All right. Is there anybody who doesn't know that it's 15? Because that's right. I mean, I'll go over it, but you got to be honest. I got to go over it. All right, look up here. What's my denominator on this one?
5.
What's my denominator on this one?
3.
What's the bigger one?
5.
All right, so I put the bigger one here. Does 3 go into 5 evenly?
No.
Double it. Does 3 go into 10 evenly?
No.
What do I do now?
Again.
Triple it. Triple it. Does 5 go into 15 evenly?
Yes.
Bingo. That's the one we want. Now watch. 2 times what is 15? I'm sorry, 5 times what is 15?
3.
So put a 3. 3 times what is 15? So put a 5. Everybody with me so far?
Yeah.
All right. Now help me out here. What is the first one going to be?
6.
What is the second one going to be?
5.
Do I have the same denominator?
Yes.
All right. So my final answer is going to be 5 to the what power? 11 over 15. If the bases are the same, what must you do with the exponents? Must add them. And in order to add or subtract, you must have the same what? Yes, excellent. All right, here's your assignment. I want you to do 20 and 21, and then I'm going to play the video, and I'm going to let her explain it. So work page 20 and 21 right now, quietly. Time we get out. Yeah, go ahead. Come on, 20 and 21. Put a mark by the ones you need help with, because those are the ones you're going to pay close attention to the video. And when she explains it, if you need me to explain it, I will. She'll be back in a minute. If the bases are different, here's how you're going to work that.
What number is it?
All right, read it. All right, look up here. 10.5 is really the square root of 10, right? So put the square root of 10 times the square root of 2. It's the same as this. They're trying to help you see that, that they're the same. So that's going to be the square root of 20. If the bases are not the same, listen to me, you can't add the exponents, but you can work it like that. If the bases are not the same, you cannot add the exponents. Now I'm going to try to figure out where she is in this book. What topic is this one, you know?
Eight.
It is 8, thanks. All right, so while you're working, let me try to find this. Come on, try to do something, all right? I mean, put a mark by it if you can't do it, but try.
You guys thought we were... Gosh. Yes, well, this a to the 7th, 6th, and b to the 9th, 10th, this a could be a to the... 1. All right, so m to the 0 times n squared, all raised to the 1/5. Well, first of all, I know that m to the power of 0 is 1. So this essentially crosses the. So that gives me 2 to the 5, 6.
Does that look like
it? Can I multiply these? No, because they have different roots.
All right, you guys keep working. I'll try to find it. Well, where is that square root of 2 and cube root of 2? I don't see. Yeah, it is. All right, well, keep working, and then I'll play it. Appreciate the help. I'm going to pass out these papers. I do want to go over them, but I can't go over it today. Pass this all the way back to Heather. Brandon. Mr. Frank. Mr. Plill. All the way back. Jacob. Mr. Hoffman. Miss Kayla, all the way to the back. Miss Amy. No name on this one.
Right there.
Hanley?
That's a six. She's not here.
How about who did not get one? Because there's no name on this one.
Take a good check.
That looks like you.
Yeah.
Sure.
Yep.
Well, you want me to give you a grade, right?
Yeah.
So make sure I give you a grade for that. Let me go do it right now. All right, stay focused now. All right, who am I looking for? Was that fair for you? Anna?
No.
Was that test fair for you? Because you came in kind of late, didn't you?
Yeah.
Right.
I'm
Right, I'm saying, is that a fair, should I mark that grade down?
I don't know how you see it.
I think I should probably let you go on this one. All right. Peyton, I don't know what to say. All I have is Emily's. Hey, guys, are we working? If it shows up, I'll shut. Is there a grade in the computer? Oh, that was yours? Do you sometimes not write your name on stuff?
That happens quite a bit.
Yeah. That's fine. See, it's a good
job. Come on,
stay focused.
Yeah, it's not.
What?
It's not.
Yeah, give me both of them. Try. Put a mark on. Probably do. Different class. Try. If you have the same base, you add exponents. Put a mark if you can't do it, but try anyway. All right, I tell you what, stop. Let's just watch it.
And our rational exponent form. Let's see what we have right here. Now I have the square root of 2 times the cube root of 2. Can I multiply these? No, because they have different roots. Here's a square root. Here's a cube root. Can't do it. Different roots. Can't do it because they have different roots. Well, what if it's...
All right, look at what's going on. We cannot multiply because this is a cube root, that's a square root. But you can do it this way. Watch.
In rational exponent form. Well, we see that we have the same base here, so we can use our rules of exponents. So I'm multiplying two terms with the same base. That means I add my exponent. So I would have 2 to the 1 half plus 1 third. So that gives me 2 to the 5, 6. Well, now that I have that in rational exponent form, I could rewrite this in...
Now, she didn't show you how she did the denominator. I did, okay? The least common denominator is 6. So she did that kind of in her head, all right? But, again, you can't multiply like this, but you can do it this way by adding the exponents.
Radical form, and I know that that would be the 6 root of 2 to the 5th. So I could go about it that way to write this in a different form, but just looking at the square root of 2 times the cube root of 2, can't multiply them.
Notice what she did. She took this, she used the 6 as the root, and she used the top number as the exponent.
Because they have different roots. All right, now let's try dividing. Let's see what we have here. Well, once again, we have the same root. Well, that means that we can divide. This is the equivalent of saying the square root of 10 over 2. Well, 10 over 2 is 5, so that is the square root of 5.
They both have the square root, so all she did was reduce. Excuse me. 10 divided by 2 is 5.
5. Nothing to pull out there. Let's take a look and see what that looks like for our rational exponent form. Remember, we write this as 2 to the 1 half. Ooh, I'll just rewrite that. I'm skipping a step for you. 5 times 2 to the 1 half over 2 to the 1 half. Well, remember, I can write this as 5 to the 1 half over 2 to the 1 half over 2 to the 1 half. Well, guess what? These cancel out, and I'm left with...
All right. Now look, I know this is kind of far-fetched, but I need you to try to understand it. So watch. She broke the 10 up as 5 times 2 to the 1 half power. Then she put the 1 half on the 5, and she put the 1 half on the 2. Then she reduced this one and this one. So it really wasn't that bad. And that reduces to what it is. It's the square root of 5. So she did it two ways. Okay.
5 to the 1 half. Well, 5 to the 1 half is the square root of 5. So I get the same answer whether I'm dealing with radical form or rational exponent form. All right, it is time. Big study edge tip for you. The properties of exponents that we've been doing so much with also apply to expressions with rational exponents. So those same rules are going to apply. So we want to keep those in mind whenever we have a little bit more complicated expressions. So let's get some practice here. So we have x to the 1 third to the 1 half. So let's see what we can do. Well, I know that I can write that as x to the...
All right. It's a power to a power. Look at it carefully. It's a power to a power. Do I add them? Do I multiply them? Do I subtract them? Or do I divide those two? You got to multiply a power to a power. Very good.
1 third times 1 half.
Don't start moving on me.
So that's just x to the 1 sixth.
We
got
time.
It. All right, what do we have here? Well, I have the square root of 7 cubed. Well, I know that I can write that as the square root of 7 cubed. These are equivalent. Well, I know that that right there then is 7 squared times 7. Well, 7 squared is a perfect square. That means I can pull out a 7. So I get 7 root 7 for my solution here.
All right, look at this one. This one gives you 3 sevens. But if you have 3, that gives you a pair. So you can take 1 out, and you're left with 1 on the inside. Some of this is, you know, it is. It's a little weird, but I need you to try.
All right, let's keep on going. All right, a to the 1 half, b to the 2 fifths times a to the 2 thirds, b to the 1 half. Well, I'm multiplying here, so I can use my commutative property of multiplication to rearrange this. So this is equivalent to a to the 1 half times a to the 2 thirds times b to the 2 fifths times b to the 1 half. So that way I've got my a's next together and my b's next together. Well, I'm multiplying terms with the same base, so I can add their exponents.
Add
that's a to the 1 half plus 2 thirds. So that is 1 half times 1 half plus 2 thirds. That gives me 7 sixths. There we go. And b to the 2 fifths times b to the 1 half. Well, I add these exponents right here. 2 fifths plus 1 half gives me b to the 9 tenths.
Now, what she's not showing you is how to find the least common denominator. But she's still adding those two fractions. To me, she should have gone off to the side and showed you how to add the fractions. She's assuming you got that. Okay. All right, that's what she did. All right, well, we'll do something tomorrow.
Yeah. job from Iowa. Yeah.
Oh, I know.
Is it red as fuck?
There he is.
I saw him 12 again.
Yeah.
You know, I did. You did, sir. You did? Kind of. Alright, you don't have to do stupid things. What? You don't have to do it. I used to.
You
know this.
Hey, you.
Oh, because you're a Jew.
Wow.
You know, you could have made a
joke. It was a good joke. And then you're fucking
your joke.
Hey,
did anyone ever hear this? Yeah.
No, it's stupid.
We
just
feel fucking scared.
Why are you so
stupid? It's kind of not even
as nice to it. Let me find you. Your face on your face.
Whoa, Josh, whoa. Whoa.
It was a good joke. I just thought of it, and then you just made it terrible.
I didn't.
You just thought that?
I didn't. Well, Kathy didn't understand either.
Yeah,
yeah.
Well, after he told me.
Yeah, after he told me too, I understand. I didn't think you
would. I
wonder if you
would. Hey, it's out of
here, bro. It's hard.
I never talked
about it. It was pretty fun, actually. I just sat in the hallway.
In the hallway.
You said you would come out from the room pretty big, so I didn't do it.
Thank you. Sarah? Jennifer? Daniel? Jake? Maddie? Daniel? All right, I want to come around and just give you credit for that 8, 9, and 10, so have that out, please. I need you working on these two quietly. About another 2 minutes. No, I put it off. I actually. Chapter 3, I didn't have any good material, so I didn't do it.
So there's no test tomorrow?
No test tomorrow. Let's see, Caleb. Yep. All right, look up here and watch now. This next test, which probably won't be until next week, but it's not going to count on the new marking. I mean, it's going to count on the new marking period. So if I test you next week, it's not going to count on this one because there's no way I'm going to be able to get it done. All right, so look up here. Well, to figure out volume of anything, it's going to be big B times H, always. And big B stands for whatever the bottom is. So put area of the bottom, area of base. If it comes to a point, if you were absent yesterday, it's the same thing, only you have to divide by 3. If it comes to a point. So make sure you understand that. No matter what it is, okay, if it's this pyramid, you would divide by 3. Okay? Anything that comes to a point. All right, so look right here. The bottom is a circle, and most kids know that a circle is pi radius squared, and the height is 20. Well, pi is 3.14, the radius. Now look here, this says diameter. So some kids are going to put 8 times 8. And that's going to be wrong because that's your diameter and the formula says radius. Make sure you split that in half. And what else some kids do is they're like, well, heck, man, you got 2 4s, just use an 8. No, it's not that way, okay? All right, so clear your calculator and press. I know that 4 times 4 is 16. So put 16 times 20 times 3.14, and hopefully I did that right. So I get 1004.8, and put cubic inches because volume is 3 dimension. Now look over here. This one is the same numbers, but it comes to a point. So divide by 3. And your answer is going to be 334.9 cubic inches. That's all you do. It takes, believe it or not, now this is hard for me to believe. All right. It takes 3 of these to fill up 1 of these. All right, now I want to show that, and I meant to show this to another class. So just give me a second. Let me see if I can find it. Here it is right here. All right, watch this animation or demonstration. Alright, now I know it's not the same diagram, but it takes 3 of these to equal 1 of the cylinder. So 3 of these to equal 1 of these. That's why you take this and divide by 3 to get that. Alright, put away your bell work, please. Today we're going to go into the pyramid. So take a look at that square pyramid, and we're going to draw this, okay? It's easy stuff. This is really easy. So draw a square. And put a dot at about 12 o'clock. Now, connect the dot with the vertices right here. Catch up with me, okay? Connect the dot with the vertices. Now, we need some information here. Let's say that the height, straight down, let's just use an easy number. Let's say 20 is the height. Let's say this piece right here is 5. Now watch and listen. Put volume equals big B times H. But it comes to a point, so I have to do what? Excellent. Divide by 3. Is everybody with me on the formula? All right. What does big B stand for? base area. Well, on the cone, it was a circle. What is it on this one? What image is it? It's a square. So it's going to be side times side. Well, if it's side times side, how much is this side?
10.
Why would you say 10? Yeah, that's what I would say too, that this is 5, so I would double it. So I would say 10 times 10. And that's a very good observation, and that's what I would do as well. Is everybody clear that the bottom is 10 times 10 and the height is 20? But we must divide by 3 because it comes to a point. So clear your calculator, and let's see if we all get the same thing. So 10 times 10 I know is 100 times 20 divided by 3. All right, I get 666.7. I'm going to round that off, okay? Put cubic inches because it's volume. If it's close enough, I'm going to give it to you. One thing I noticed on that computer program, some kids knew they were right, but they didn't enter enough digits. So if you get stuck, try to put a few more. I'd put a bunch of them, and usually it goes through. All right, if you understood that, the only other one I have to show you is this one. So draw a circle, and then make it a sphere by doing something like this. It kind of gives the impression of a ball. So put sphere, generally known as a ball. All right, soccer, baseball, whatever, basketball. Is everybody with me so far? All right, now this formula, I have to memorize it. Okay, in fact, I forgot it, so I had to look it up online. But I want you to memorize it, okay? So put volume of a sphere equals 4 over 3 pi radius cubed. Now, I'm going to make that cube a little bigger because sometimes I think it's a square and it's wrong. I can get the 4 over 3, but this one is cubed. Okay, now, watch what I'm going to do here. I'm going to give you the diameter. So from here to here, I'm going to tell you the diameter is 15. Now, that's a little oddball number, okay? But so what? So look up here. Here's how I work it. Now, if you do it a different way and you get the same answer, I don't care, you know, as long as it's your work and it works, okay? So look up here. I do it this way. I do all the top numbers. So I do 4 times pi times the radius. Now, if you use 15, obviously you're going to miss it. So don't copy the 15. Divided by 3. The last thing I do is divide by 3. Well, but 15 is wrong. What would the radius be?
7.5.
Yes, that, so that makes it really worse. But put 7.5 3 times. But I want to make sure you got that concept. So clear your calculator. Here's how I would do it. Now look, I don't like pressing 7.5 3 times, so I'm going to show you a little more sophisticated because this calculator is not horrible. So look here. Clear it out. Try it with me now. Press 7.5. You see this XY key right here? Press that XY key and raise it to the third power. That should be the same thing, you know, as doing it 3 times. And 3 isn't even hideous. If it was 8, it would be like torture, okay? That key would be good. So press equals. We'll try it again. Times 3.14. And I messed up there, darn it. So let me back up. Watch again. Press 7.5. Hit the XY key, for those of you that didn't get it the first time, to the third power, and then times 3.14, and then times 4, and then the last thing you do is divide by 3. Now, hopefully in all of that discussion, I didn't miss something, but I get 1766. Did anybody else get 1766?
I
All right, we're going to stay with that. Again, I do all the top numbers, and then the last thing I do is divide by 3. So everybody understand that concept? All right, your assignment's real easy, and here it is. Now, keep in mind, I know you're going to finish, so just work smoothly, okay? Don't take a break, but if you work smoothly, it's okay. All right, here we go. Now, one thing I want you to do, besides copy this, is to check some of your answers. I won't make you check them all. But occasionally, I want to see you looking in the back and put a check mark. When I walk around, if I don't see a check mark, I'm going to assume you didn't look. And some kids aren't honest. They're just going to say, oh, I'm just going to put a check mark. I don't want you to live like that, okay? It's not worth it. All right? Just every now and then, flip back there and check some of them. That's all I want you to do. Just give it to me tomorrow. And put Astro on it. Make sure you draw the diagram. Thank you. arcade. Thank you.
years.
Good. Yeah, they're not too bad.
This is a complete.
About a year.